Well, talk to me a little bit about this month is Prostate Cancer Awareness Month. It's very important for men to know that they are at high risk for this disease. Tell me a little bit why that is so important, Dr. Gaillard.
First, it affects many men around us. Many of us are at risk for prostate cancer. It's very important to have at least a baseline PSA level at the age of 50. And to some people at higher risk, like African-Americans or those with family history of prostate cancer, they need to have it earlier, probably starting at the age of 40. It's always a good idea to talk to your primary care physician about PSA for screening. It's a simple blood test, and get his input and your risk factors.
Dr. Gaillard, can you tell, how can someone tell if they are at high risk? I think that's a very important point.
If there is family history, like people in your family with prostate cancer, brothers, father, and uncles, it's a good idea. Also, breast cancer has been correlated with prostate cancer, and African Americans were reported to be at higher risk, so many screenings should start a bit earlier for those at the age of 40.
So tell us a little bit about proton therapy. A lot of people have not heard about this. What is proton therapy, and how does proton therapy work?
If we diagnose prostate cancer, and the best outcome is when you have diagnosis early in the stage of disease, there are treatment options, among which is surgery and radiation. And for any stage, any age, any patient, stage by stage, radiation is equal to surgery in terms of outcome. And proton therapy is a specific form of radiation. There is a particle therapy. It goes unlike conventional radiation where it goes through the body. Proton therapy goes in developing or depositing the energy at the target and stops. So most of the radiation goes by the particle therapy, stopping at the prostate, for example, and not hurting the other organs around. So it's less side effects, it's better quality of life. It is probably the best treatment for prostate cancer.
What would you say is one of the biggest advantages of proton therapy over, would you say, surgery or radiation?
The quality of life and the side effects. So by the proton therapy going just to the target and stopping at the target, only 30% of the radiation goes outside. You spare the normal body 70% of unnecessary radiation that is given by conventional radiation treatments. So you have a targeted treatment that goes to the target and stops. And it does 10% more biological damage to the cancer than the conventional radiation. So you have more effectiveness, less side effects, less problems with the rectum, less problems with the bladder, better quality of life afterwards with the same cure rates as surgery without the surgery. Surgery, on the other hand, has a higher risk of incontinence or losing control of urine, has a higher risk of losing potency or erection for men, and the quality of life is compromised immediately after the surgery because of the catheter and the pain and so on. All that is avoided with proton therapy. So it's effective. In the meantime, better quality of life and tolerance during the treatment.
And Dr. Now,
conventional radiation, yeah, and then surgery.
Sure. And now that you've piqued everyone's interest, Dr. Gaillard, Dave, we would like to know the big question people have now, Dave. What was your experience like with proton therapy, your side effects, and how did the treatment feel?
Well, I got to tell you something. I've had a wonderful experience with this whole process.